watching PTS in news. I'm Shen Wupei. The wedding banquet cluster infection has spread from Jiayi to Taipei, with 6 cases confirmed. One expert says people should not shake hands or embrace at wedding banquets due to risk of infection.
Jiayi City's Nice Prince Hotel is at the center of Taiwan's latest COVID-19 cluster. So far, 6 people have tested positive, including one as far away as Taipei. One expert says restaurants and banquet halls are common sites for cluster infections due to the enclosed space, people taking off their masks to eat, chatting while eating, toasting and shaking hands. He also says you don't have to eat at the same table as an infected person to get infected.
婚宴那一种场合，很多亲友可能会握手啊，可能会有一些其他接触到受污染的手啊，或者是受污染的一个物体的机会，所以在餐厅用餐的时候特别要注意。
The Central Epidemic Command Center says the cluster originated with a pet store employee. 12 Taipei hotels and clinics began administering BNT vaccines to children on the 21st. The batch of vaccines expires on the 23rd, and officials hope all the vaccines can be used up.
可以打的，尽量在3天把它打完，这3天量还可以。可是如果过了3月23号，就没有疫苗可以打了。
With the imported daily case count exceeding 100 now, many are worried that the government will decide to extend the length of quarantine again. Chen Shizhong says this isn't necessarily the case.
以这样的一个进来的一个，在我们边境上面，事实上还没有形成这压力。那不会因为这样的一个数目而对我们检疫的天数有所改变。那当然持续还要观察。
Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je and his wife Chen Peiqi have both recently commented that if the government had gotten BNT vaccines sooner, not as many people would have had to die. Asked about his comments, Chen Shizhong said hindsight is 20/20.
Previously, DPP legislator Chen Ming-wen's footprint overlapped with a Jiayi principal that tested positive for COVID-19. However, he attended a public event the day after getting tested and pulled down his mask to give a speech. The Jiayi County Health Bureau said Chen violated the regulations.
Democratic Progressive Party legislator Chen Ming-wen recently attended a public event in Jiayi County. He gave a speech during the event and pulled down his mask in order to address the crowd. A Kuomintang Jiayi County councillor posted a photo of Chen at the event on her Facebook to show his violation of disease prevention regulations. Chen previously attended an event where a participant leader tested positive and was ordered to get tested. He got tested on March 19th and then attended a public event on March 20th, during which he pulled down his mask. These actions violated self-health management regulations.
应该这段时间就要做好自主的健康管理，不应该要外出。那就算你可以外出的话，也应该把口罩戴好。看他脱口罩，好的时机是不是符合我们的要求？好，那第二个在自主健康，我们都是尽量避免。
Health and Welfare Minister Chen Shizhong tried to defend the legislator, saying it needs to be seen if the legislator's removal of his mask during self-health management violated any regulations. He also said people undergoing self-health management should avoid taking public transport and coming into contact with unknown people. Chen Ming-wen confessed to attending the public event, apologized, and said he is willing to receive any punishment.
PCR的一个裁剪，呈现是阴性。
那我个人觉得我也打了3针哈，那应该是没有问题。那在住址的时候，口罩不慎脱落。裁剪3天以内是尽量避免到公共场所。那如果真的需要外出的话，一定要戴口罩。以这样的一个行为的话，是会违反传染病防治法。我们来处罚3000到15000。
Jiayi County's Health Bureau said Chen was tested on March 19th and attended a public event on March 20th. This was a violation of the Communicable Disease Prevention Act, which carries a fine of $3,000 to $15,000. Chen asked the highest fine to be levied, and the Bureau will comply. The Bureau also said there is no need to worry, as Chen and the confirmed case were both wearing masks when their footprints overlapped, and Chen subsequently tested negative.
The Atomic Energy Council delivered a report addressing Japan's dumping of radioactive wastewater into the sea. It said an 8-member observation group will travel to Japan on March 23rd and visit Fukushima Daiichi Nuclear Power Plant Unit 1 reactor on March 25th.
The Japanese government intends to dump radioactive wastewater from Fukushima Daiichi Nuclear Power Plant's Unit 1 reactor into the sea. A team from the International Atomic Energy Agency visited Japan from February 14th to 18th to learn more and collect seawater samples for independent analysis and verification. Taiwan asked to participate but was rejected. The Atomic Energy Council said on March 21st that an 8-member observation team will leave for Japan on March 23rd and visit the plant on March
25th. 对，是的，我们不敢在第一时间说明的原因。除了这个原因以外，还有最大的一个原因，我们怕有些变故。
AEC Minister Xie Xiaoxing told the legislature that the trip is 5 days long, but the actual number of working days is only 1.5. One entire day will be spent at the plant to learn more about wastewater equipment and facilities. Opposition legislators said the group should follow the IAEA and collect seawater samples.
IAEA没有做到这一块，确定吗？
是的，我们现在最新的讯息告诉我是这样的。好，但有必要的话，我觉得还是要争取一下了。是的。An
independent legislator said the names of the group members need to be disclosed to ensure its capabilities. The AEC responded that the Council of Agriculture, Ocean Conservation Administration, and Environmental Protection Administration all wanted to send their people but decided not to participate this time following a video conference. Another legislator demanded that the group submit a report within a month after returning to Taiwan.
Now bring some other stories from around Taiwan. Taiwan Railways will be able to hike tourism trade fare if amendment to the Railway Act are passed. The Taiwan Railway Labor Union and Taiwan Railway Union are planning protests on March 23rd. One man was trapped and injured while chasing a waterfall in Taichung. 13 firefighters and rescue workers work with the National Airborne Service Corps to rescue him. As of this March, the CDC reviewed 294 reports and concluded 90% of the cases had nothing to do with the adverse effect of the vaccines. The Kuomintang is calling for criteria to be relaxed. 29 embezzlement cases at a bank with a loss of 1.6 billion NT dollars were reported in the last 5 years. The Financial Supervisory Commission Chair Huang Tianmu said it has planned to establish a mechanism for combating this happening again.
After the U.S. and Taiwan both announced higher interest rates, the TAIEX opened up on the 21st. Electronic and steel stocks, including TSMC, saw the largest gains. Financial Supervisory Commission Chair Huang Tianmu told lawmakers higher U.S. rates historically have a positive impact on the stock market.
外资的确这段时间卖的比较多，但是仍然有汇入了。那二月份汇入了十二亿左右。
Huang Tianmu says many economies have declined by over 10% this year, while Taiwan's has only fallen 4%. In addition, listed companies reported revenues of 6.5 trillion NT dollars in February, which was an increase of 12.65% from a year ago. Yield and profit earning ratios also looked good. The Directorate General of Budget, Accounting and Statistics is forecasting economic growth this year of 4.42%. The Financial Supervisory Commission, meanwhile, has its hands full with a slew of embezzlement cases at banks, with 29 cases and losses of 1.6 billion NT dollars reported in the last 5 years.
那结果还是一直不断的发生。最近这几个案子有一个特征，就是它不是在行内做金流，它是到他个人的客户账户中去做，所以这部分要强化。The
FSC says its plans for combating this include re-establishing a culture of integrity, improving accountability mechanisms, and establishing financial penalties and strengthening education. It will also take a look at what other countries do to prevent embezzling among bank executives.
Now with some top stories from around the world. U.S. President Joe Biden returned to the White House at Havel Chapel this week to Brussels to meet with NATO leaders to discuss Russia's war in Ukraine, but he will not travel to Ukraine. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky said that Israel will have to live with the choices it makes on whether to help protect Ukraine against the Russian invasion, addressing the Knesset via video link. China's financial hub of Shanghai closed its Disney resort until further notice as it reported a record daily surge in the local COVID-19 infections, with authorities scrambling to rein in the Omicron variant. According to reports, Taiwan People's Party Chair柯文哲and Kuomintang Chairperson Eric Chu may collaborate in Kaohsiung and Taipei elections. The KMT will back the TPP's Kaohsiung City Mayoral candidate in exchange for the TPP support of Jiang Wan and in the Taipei City Mayoral election.
According to reports, Taiwan People's Party Chair and Taipei City Mayor Ke Wen-je intends to run in the 2024 presidential election. He will hold a spring banquet at the end of March with diplomats in attendance, where he is expected to announce his foreign affairs and cross-strait policy blueprints.
各国在台湾的大使馆，那这个部分事实上我们是持续做很多的文化交流啦，很多的相关的互动是蛮多的。而实际的访美，大概今年度看起来可能性不高了。
The U.S. government is also keeping an eye on potential presidential candidates. Kuomintang Chair Eric Chu is planning a visit in May to the U.S., where he is expected to call on important public figures and deliver a speech. Both Ke and Chu are actively making preparations. There is the possibility of cooperation between the two parties. According to reports, the KMT will back the TPP's Kaohsiung City mayoral candidate in exchange for the TPP support of Jiang Wan An in the Taipei City mayoral election.
大家彼此尊重，我在媒体，在这个不透过任何媒体的放话。
主席，那你让这回事，没有礼让或交换。
哎，不透过媒体的放话。
我想站在民众的角度，希望看到的是全民和，而希望看到的是政党的利益不要凌驾在人民的利益之上。
When asked when he will formally declare his candidacy for Taipei City Mayor.KMT legislator Jiang Wan-an said the party's Taipei headquarters is prioritizing city councilor nominations, and there will be a timetable after a certain period of time passes. Reports estimate that it will be in May.
Thank you for watching PTS Asia News. I'm Sun Lupei. See you next time.